I do. So you'll be there. I mean, I'll try. I already promised that I'd drop by this thing with Nick.
Yeah. Lily, you're a hard rock.
I'm 23. I just recently graduated from FIT, and I have this best friend. She's kind of my favorite thing.
Let's talk about Nick.
He's kind of amazing. He's probably the sweetest guy I've ever met.
What about your job?
I mean, it's in fashion, so that's good. And I'm learning a lot.
You don't have AC.
Thanks. Why are we talking like this?
This is how we talk now. tonight?
What?
Thank you for that. You are going.
Am I?
About to club and sack you myself.
How much fun?
Extremely. Astonishingly.
You gotta work.
Why are you gonna quit?
I can't.
I have to maintain this lab. Eventually, we all just drift apart. Because, like, that's what the universe is doing. You know? Drifting, fading, dying, that's it. And then one day, you wake up and realize you're dating a meteoroid when all the girl really wants is to be whisked off by a shooting star, you know?
I thought they were the same thing.
The point is, you want the dream we all do. Eventually, you have to go up and settle for something more realistic. Like a quarry rock. Or worse, like the Heideki rock. Like the kind you find in those sad in-flight magazines.
Yeah, you lost me.
That's life for most people. I mean, not ours, of course, but for most people.
Yeah, but I mean, but it actually gets, like, better with age.
My vintage motorcycle jacket. Oh, so Jess posted pictures of last night. And it appears you checked in at Canopy around 11. Eek. And then you were back in BK 30 minutes later. It all makes sense now. You know, you really should work on a socially viable approach to reputation.
No, wait, what makes sense?
Nick, all over this model check. That's why you left, isn't it?
No, wait. No, I mean, that's like your job.
Yeah, but it's the same one every time.
Ben isn't here, is he?
I don't know, he's separated now, he kind of does what he wants.
Good day.
Yeah, it's actually really 2100.
And what's Donna doing on the ticker?
Actually, I think it's 18 and a quarter.
In the inventory?
In transit with an estimated delivery
15
minutes ago.
Hey, baby, it's Nick. Listen, I feel like such shit about last night. Like, seriously, shit just, I don't know, shit just got mad crazy. You know how fucked up my schedule can get. But, you know, work now, live later. Bet you probably looked out of shit last night. Tell you what, drop by my show tonight, okay? Give me a ring. We can make up for last night.
Good. Shall we?
Yeah, I don't want to see Nick.
Are you being serious?
Yes. But Beatrice is having people over, so we could go there and sit down. Come on. Please.
I'd fuck me.
I'd fuck you.
Really? Well, yeah. If I was a guy. I'd stick my penis in your vagina. Totally. Wow, thanks. She's just, you know, waiting for Nick to go and switch over his film or whatever bullshit excuse he made up to leave. And then it wasn't until the delivery guy turns up that she thought, wait a minute, I wonder if Nick's actually arrived back yet. And of course he was nowhere to be found. Something about your top.
It is, I was there.
You're absolutely... He was trying to get material for his portfolio because he's trying to find
Lily. It was material for his fucking wank bag.
No, it was not.
It was.
Well, he's going to be a very serious for him.
He's going to be a very serious photographer.
And he had to go because he had... No, but really, it was very sweet. And he felt very bad that he had to leave afterwards. And he came back and he made me dinner and he apologized. It was really very sweet. And so, you know, those kind of things happen.
I have something really exciting to tell you.
What is it?
It's the wonderful news.
Right. Everyone,
hi, it's on my app, please. I'm
just going to look out. Everyone, shut the fuck up!
So, yes. I have some really exciting news. I am pleased to say... My time here in this wonderful city has been quite amazing. And it wouldn't have been half as amazing without you guys being part of it. So, it is with great sadness that I say, I will not be taking residence here much longer. I have a job in London with my dad's label, and I am, sadly, leaving in 7 days. In New York.
Find a free man, that's awesome.
Really crazy, but what else would you expect?
Yeah. Yeah. Guess you just need a change.
I just want to go myself.
Be surprised.
How are you fine? You look like your dog just died.
No, I'm fine. We were roommates at FIT.
How would you describe your time together?
Well, I think she actually learned a lot from me. I mean, I'm not saying that Kat, like, isn't smart, but she just might be kind of disadvantaged from all of the drugs.
Is this a period that she's overcome?
Yes and no. It's hard to tell with those kinds of people.
You don't seem to have a high opinion of her.
No, it's... Okay, so this is going to sound really horrible, but when I say 8.5, Kat thinks I mean penis size, so yeah. Pretty hard to talk with her about anything that's... anything.
I'm assuming you're not excited for
her. No, she has a whole new city of people to fuck, that's awesome.
So you don't feel happy for her?
I mean, it's not like it even fucking matters. I don't need her.
Why didn't you tell her off right there?
Oh my god, can we please talk about something else?
Okay, so you hit a car with a beer. Tell us about that.
I was imagining Kat's head.
Start with, once upon a time I was born, and shortly after leaving the nest, I flew over a few blocks to Agnes' peaceful tree, where I pretended to be a harmless, hardworking bird, but lately I've sucked, and I need to pull my shit together, and tell Agatha thank you, for I owe you my life. Tell me something good. Tell me you brought me coffee.
I did not.
I genuinely hope this is some sort of phase. Awesome, you're hilarious. Now get...
fucking awesome. I know it'll be. This is going to work out. Can you just postpone it? What? I can't. They'll get someone else. This is a career move. How could you not understand that?
I get it.
Then what do they feel? You're going to be big, Lily. I knew it since the day we met. You're really. Tonight.
Okay, I'll think about it.
There are a lot of interesting people.
So the 17th, that's a Friday, right?
Yeah. More than enough time for us to have fun.
It'll be like sophomore year in Harbor.
Crazy I am. Anyway, I'm shooting his lookbook and we totally hit it off. He He takes me to some fucking penthouse, and we do some coke. I tell him that you're in fashion, and I know how much you need a backer, so I got you, like, a shitload of contacts. And
okay.
I was really just thinking of you, and, you know, I want to respect you and shit, and I don't think I'm doing a good job at that. God, excuse me, I am high as a motherfucker right now.
She said she'd make the best of things.
Yeah, for her. Doesn't exactly include me.
I believe you and Kat have a history at art galleries.
Yeah, we do.
Tell me about it.
I don't know, we've like always, go as characters. Like, we'd pretend to be French students, and then anyone you would meet at the gallery, you'd keep on going with it. And Kat always thought it was fucking hysterical. There was this one time we ended up back at this photographer's apartment, and I don't know, we were pretending to be British, but my accents are really, really bad. And I'm pretty sure he knew that it was complete bullshit because I kept on, like, just saying these insane things, like, writing and Cheerio. I don't know, Kat couldn't stop laughing. But he might have been too fucked up to really notice. I can't believe that. No, actually, I am. just would really rather own my own store.
So does that mean that you don't create your work?
No. I kind of tried. It didn't really work out the store, but I guess I'm not very good.
I'm sorry, but I mean, that is complete bullshit. I mean, why else would you go into that medium? To collect a bunch of old shit from other people that's not art. The whole reason why you got into fashion was to create something and leave it behind. And that's why I'm not gonna do this. You know what I think? I think that you're afraid of being judged. That's not what I'm doing. What? Well, tell me I'm wrong. For Valentina, I love it. Two of them, nice, bro, very nice. So, are they coming with? Actually, let's let the ladies make up their own minds, because females are independent and intelligent. I'm Colin, by the way, how are you? Hey, buddy, can you get us started? How long does it take to get clothes? Check out. Okay, how about you go get us a cab?
Absolutely. Love you. Big cock.
Okay, so that's someone that you know?
Yeah, I guess.
Wow.
Incredible.
Goodness.
Hey, let me give you my number.
Okay.
Here, let me help you. Do you want to come to a party and you can bring your friend?
Oh, shit, no, I work really late.
Everything's so goddamn bright. Because this is what we normal people call daytime. Come down. Got some of your shit. I packed it up for you. Thought you might need it. Pass it. Bring it with you.
I have have a bunch of other things I was going to sell that I think you should have.
Thanks, as long as I can sell them. Why would you do that?
I was just kidding.
So, how's Nick?
Nick is good.
You never told me what happened that pasted you up.
You're selling this? It's lovely, but I don't know. I bought this for you, Kurt. Did you? It's funky and I like it.
And keep it, I don't care.
You keep ass. So the total comes to $954.
Super.
Let's talk about your career.
What about it?
Do you enjoy where you're working?
Am I a masochist?
Is that what you consider Agatha to be?
No. I think the only thing that could possibly bring her pleasure is black leather against her thighs.
How do you see yourself moving forward? Don't you want to create your own line?
Well, yeah, but I don't really think that's an option right now. I mean, if you know anyone who wants to give money to a 23-year-old, please let me know.
Then would you say you're stuck?
No, you're making this out so much worse than it is. It's just... Okay, so maybe the boutique is cold and dead and lifeless, but, I mean, I am making a lot of great contacts I can use later in my life.
Do you really mean that?
No.
Let's talk about Henry.
What?
Do you want to make love to him?
Maybe? Sure, why not?
What do you look for in a guy?
Well, a career in fashion or art, film, photography, music. I mean, I can't help it. I like guys who create.
Do you think this stems from the fear of expressing yourself creatively?
Wow. I just went to fashion school, so I don't have a problem creating. I mean, it's just not my thing right now.
Uh-huh.
Really? I think I've made some really bold choices with my life.
Here, get your ass up. You got plans tonight? My boy Dan is DJing at the club right now. Fucking DJ Dan, you met him, what, like 5 times? Come on, come through.
Texting.
Yeah, fashion girl by day.
Yeah, not your head, eating disorder. Oh my God, I am not. Think about that night.
We don't have
have to talk it out, but really.
Those models, they're all so tall and beautiful and flawless, and they have this perfect food. Oh, no, there I was with them. I was just thinking of you.
Wait, I thought there was just one.
Oh, come on. The rings and everything gets wet. Does it really matter if it rains again an hour later?
What?
Really soft mannequin.
Wait, you slipped with one of your models?
Oh my god, none of them can hear Lily. That's what I'm trying to tell you. Hey, remember what I said about eye contact? Hey, make some waffles.
I can't. I have to go home.
No, come on. Make some waffles first.
I have to go to work.
Well, I'm going to come with you.
Yeah.
Come on. I'm watching work. I'm making noodles.
I don't think so.
Jesus. Oh, you're so much nicer when you're wasted.
Hey, what?
Jesus, Lily, could you please not start this morning? Oh, my God.
No, I'm taking this because this is my face!
Oh,
fuck you. Are you ready? So, let's talk about me.
Yeah, well, that was obviously humiliating.
Then why do you put up with him?
I don't know. I just want to be with someone who could do so much better than me.
Doesn't that put you in their regard?
No, it actually means that I have really high standards.
I see.
Yeah, glad we cleared that up.
You kind of seem to be going to a tailspin.
Oh, call it what you will.
Where are your parents?
They're not here. They've moved. They have better things going on.
Don't you feel like going home?
Same thing we were just saying.
our ship.
Yeah, I was. Thanks for bringing it up.
So, buried or cremated?
Buried, cremated.
The way I see it, you can choose. It can be a turban or a bobby pin. I mean, sure, one is fun and flashy, but it goes out of style like that. Bobby pins are a bore, but they're dependable. They get the job done. No fussing with the trends, just invisible fixtures doing their job. And, like, I know a lot of guys who secretly wish they could borrow hairstyles or styles from a genre not their own. They can't, like the lawyer who is afraid of what the firm's senior partners or even his cleaning lady might think. Well, they wonder, is he a pedophile? Or worse? Like a hipster? Are you having a bad day? Henry, I got out of work early. Do you want to, like, grab a drink or something? No, that sounds great. I can be over there in a little. I just have to drop by my place.
Have fun. What are you talking about?
Henry texted, said he was with you.
We ran into each other after work.
How cute. You're like a little porcelain doll.
So, what do you want to get into tonight? I'm not tired.
Now that the night's proper fucked, I'm gonna bug off to bed.
Not even 10.
I'll see you tomorrow night.
What are you smiling about?
I've never been finger painted by a guy before.
Are you in love?
I guess.
Take one, a little, I'll see you back soon. You guys see helicopters?
There's not much to tell, really. I was in love with her, and I wasn't.
You see, it's him. talking to you.
Why not?
Because you made Henry blow you so long, he fell asleep on your vagina.
Okay, so this is about him. It's about you then.
It's always about you.
Why did you do it?
What did you expect?
Listen, do you think I'm okay with this?
Do not touch me.
Don't ruin this. I keep trying to make this fun this whole summer, and you keep fucking ruining it.
Wait, are you serious?
I'm the one ruining this? Kat, you ruined everything. You are actually destroying everything.
What are you talking about?
You hurt me and you betrayed me, Kat. And if you really felt so fucking bad about it, you wouldn't even consider leaving.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, well, you hurt me really fucking bad. It hurts like hell. Okay, and you keep on saying that I'm the one ruining this? We spent 4 years pretending that we were going to completely take over the world, and then, like, completely out of the blue, you tell me that you're moving to England a week before? And you're not moving for a job, okay? Just stop fucking saying that. You are moving because you are scared. And because you're bored, and it's easy, and you're bored, and you don't know what else to do, and it's just so easy to move when all you really think about is getting drunk, and getting high, and getting laid, and having fun, and you know what, Kat, that's because you don't really do anything. You don't fucking do anything, and nobody else seems to really realize this, because you have this awesome fucking British accent. It's like, full extent, Kat, and I can do whatever I want, cheerio, and I can be split, and tipping, and fucking going all around, tra-la-la-la-la, but because I'm blonde and hot, people think I'm whimsical, and so, oh, radio, why don't I just go ahead and fuck everyone? And I mean that literally and figuratively, can you fuck everyone?
I never meant to hurt you.
You hurt me all the time, Kat. Whenever it makes you feel better. I mean, it's not that complicated. We were really close and then she fucked it up.
Organized it.
Let's see.
She's your best friend, Lily. You can't just not be there.
No, no, I can't. I can't do the status quo.
You.
Lily, I came here to apologize.
Really? Tell me more.
What's going on here?
Well, we promised that you wouldn't let your shit get in the way of us.
You're the one that's full of shit.
I know that you don't believe that.
Get the fuck out of here.
I'm sorry. That is not how we speak to clients.
Eat a dick, Agatha!
I think it's safe to assume you don't want to be here anymore. bored. You're... what are you?
23.
You feel like you should be doing something exciting.
That's not how it is.
Oh, no, it is. Let's see what goes on here. This mindless job sucked the life out of me. That's why I hire people like Agatha. Nothing left to suck. You know. So I'm going to fire you. And look, I say go for it. Get your hands dirty, get poor, get desperate, try ecstasy, do coke. Get fucking dangerous. I mean, before you know it, you're going to be 40 with kids and a miserable mortgage. Now's the time to fucking live. Now, I know you are having a problem. Where are you going?
Stayed in touch? Yeah, we talk sometimes.
How are you feeling now?
Really good, actually. I don't know, I think that sometimes you have to split apart in order to grow. Or grow up.
And is that the profound note you want to end on?
I mean, who says that this is the end?
Thank you. Thank you.